In this demonstration, you'll see how to disable the SMB1 protocol and how to configure SMB3 encryption on a Windows Server 2019 file server using PowerShell. So we start in PowerShell ISE, which I'm going to use to run small bits of code. First bit of code, I check whether or not SMB1 is installed. I run that code, and I see that SMB1 is actually enabled. Now, by default, if you install Windows Server 2019, it will actually be disabled, but there are some scenarios where you might have enabled it to support older clients or certain devices, so it's not a given that this will actually be disabled in your environment. I clear the screen and I create a fresh new item in ISE. The next command allows me to audit SMB1 access. You should do this before disabling SMB1, just to check that there aren't any devices out there on your network that are actually using the protocol. I run that command, and now that's being audited. And I would allow that auditing to run for a few weeks, just to check that no one's using it. I open another new script item. Now, here I'm disabling SMB1. So I run the disable SMB1 command. I am prompted to restart the file server that I'm connecting to, which is SEA-SVR1, and in the background, that goes and restarts. I now go back to my original script item to check whether or not SMB1's enabled, and I see now that SMB1 is disabled on that particular file server. I clear the screen. I open up another script tab. So now I'm checking whether or not SMB3 encryption is enabled on SEA-SVR1. I run the command and I see that the encrypt data setting is set to false. So I create yet another script tab and I put the command that will turn on SMB encryption for all file shares on SEA-SVR1. I get a prompt saying, do you want to do that? I say yes. I then go back to my script block that checks whether or not encryption is enabled. I run that and I see now that encrypt data is set to true. So in that demonstration, you saw how to disable SMB1, how to audit SMB1 access, and how to enable SMB3 encryption on a file server running Windows Server 2019.